Promise blind, looking in the wrong place, wasting all my time. I don't know what I did to deserve you. I will never hurt you. God brought you my way. God must have sent you to me, 'cause he saw that I was so lonely.
Father, may you be glorified today in the name that is above every other name, I pray. Amen.
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 Let's do this.
Let's do this. Show them.
Wait. Where is the cup?
Thank you.
mazaliwa. We are gathered here today in the presence of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to witness the marriage of Oscar and Valerie. Let me just say that on the 29th of April 2017, something significant happened in Kadoma. These two were joined in holy matrimony, and they made a statement in honor of you who are gathered here today to say we shall have this ceremony in about 12 months' time, where we'll gather all of you from the diaspora and everywhere here in Cape Town. And today, I didn't believe it then. It sounded something so far-fetched, but what we are witnessing here today is a miracle. It's an honor, not only to these two, but to you. They wanted to do this for you. So today, I want to welcome you on behalf of Oscar and Valerie to this august marriage blessing. You see, marriage is a holy estate. It's a holy estate given to mankind as a gift by God. And it must not be entered into carelessly, without reverence. And what we are witnessing here today is a miracle of a maturity of love, where these two, having walked as a boyfriend and girlfriend, having courted and began to examine their relationship and got to a place where they said, our love for one another is matured, they are coming into this holy estate. And we want to thank you. We want to honor you, Oscar and Valerie, today, that you are, you know, signifying in the presence of all these witnesses that you are indeed entering into this holy estate. Let me just begin by praying. Father, today we want to thank you for the miracle of your love. We want to thank you for Oscar and Valerie. We thank you for their lives. We thank you that you are present here today. Your word says a cord, a three-strand cord, cannot be easily broken. You are present to seal this knot, this relationship. You are present here as God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to be their refuge when things are good, when things are bad, to be the provider, because you are Jehovah Jireh, when they need counsel, when they need material resources. You are present here today to say, well done, my good and faithful servants. So we want to thank you, and we want to release this ceremony into your hands, and we ask, Holy Spirit, that you lead and you guide the whole process. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Can I ask, who is here today to give this wonderful, wonderful bride to this man? Will you tell us your name? As a sign and a token of your release of this woman to this man, will you please take a right hand and put it into his left hand? Mama Oko, let's just accept that Mama is still right in the seat. I'll ask the dry our team to sit down. Valerie, Oscar, you can remain standing. And I have a few words to share with you, Oscar and Valerie. And perhaps there are some of us who are seated at the back. You know, there's an expression in English that says, if the shoe fits, wear it. I want to speak to these two. I'm not going to cover everything because of time, but I sensed the Holy Spirit say to me that these notes are yours. So I'm going to take time to just organize them and send them to you. But today, being a significant day, you know, the book of Proverbs says in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 22, to you, Oscar, as the man, says he who finds a wife finds what is good and receives favor from the Lord. You know, somebody who finds a wife finds treasure, finds something good. The book of Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25 says, husbands, love your wives. Why am I saying this to you? I'm here to explore the treasure that that a man can potentially find in their wives. Because that's what the Bible says. That's what God says. That you can find treasure, Oscar, from this woman. You can find treasure only when it starts off by you positioning yourself in that place where you say to yourself, you know what? This is going to be an unconditional love. This is going to be an unconditional commitment. This is going to be, sacrificial love. This is a journey where you are saying, you know what, I will love you. You make a decision within yourself. And there are things that, as you begin to practice out of a disposition that says, you know what, I'm going to unconditionally love my spouse, that you begin to dig, that you begin to find the treasure that's in this woman. So those are the things I would like to look at. Not all of them, but a few of them. And then I'll send you the rest, and you can make that exploration. The first thing I want to say to you, you see, this unconditional love, you know, perhaps the signature to it is an unconditional acceptance. This is God's gift to you. You have to accept it. You have to be fully persuaded that this is a gift from God.
Amen.
And guess what? You need to encourage. You know, when your wife fails, which will happen, when your wife disappoints you, which will happen, when she's under pressure, and guess what? When you sense like, you know what, yeah, she I have to be evil. You see, the power of unconditional acceptance during that time of hardship or failing can bring the healing that you so desire. You need to just unconditionally accept you in that failure. And guess what? You'll bring the best out of that particular situation. You need to stand with you. You see, every woman, okay, let me not say every woman, because some of you don't believe it, but most women There are seasons and there is a time when they are insecure. From time to time, you see, you know, they dress up and they'll go back to the house and they'll dress, they'll look at their faces and they'll make certain adjustments and they'll come back into the car and they'll go back again. And then they'll make certain adjustments. And you arrive at the party. And guess what? There is a debate that's happening within there, inside. It will take you a word to stand with him. To say, oh, you are the best dressed person on this occasion. Stand with him. Affirm him. Lift him up. Because she is a refuge to you. She is counting on you to say those particular words. And guess what? That cementing together will remain and will stand strong. And your marriage can move stronger and stronger and stronger. You need to compliment him. Don't let other people begin to compliment you outside. Don't let other men, for instance, compliment her because they are looking for you to say those words of compliment. They are counting on you to say those compliments. And they can only come from you.
Amen.
And guess what? You will bring out the treasure that's in this woman that you have found. Be the first one to compliment, not outsiders. Tell her specifically what you love her about. What is it that you love Valerie about? Tell her. She wants to hear that. Not from everybody, from anybody else. Yes, other people can say, but she wants to know from you. Tell her, you know what, Valerie, I love you. You know, because you are my best advisor. She wants to hear that. And guess what? That treasure that's hidden in this earthen vessel will come out. You see, you know, my pastor, Pastor Bonnie, says, women are like, you know, that radar that sees through situations, that sees through circumstances. And sometimes, you know, there are strong-willed women, there are weak-willed women. And if you've got a strong-willed woman, guess what? Still listen to her opinions. If you have a weak-willed one, in your own estimation, still respect her opinion. Let her express her opinion. Love to listen to her. It's a key. Validate what she is saying, you know, so that she knows that you are listening. You know, close everything else. Shut off the TV and look her into the eyes when she is talking so that you can assure her that you are listening. And guess what? Only when you do that will you be able to say, yes, I hear you, but have you seen this? But if you are doing everything else and you are not listening, you are not valuing that opinion, you begin to fight. There will be a World War III taking place in your house. So talk to him, listen, be tender with him, spend time with him and serve him. Ask God to help you and accept your wife unconditionally. Even in the midst of pain, vulnerability and weakness, love her when she annoys you, even if she disappoints you. Even if she doesn't deserve your love, love her with the kind of love that Christ shows.
Amen.
And you'll be able to unlock the hidden treasure.
Amen.
That's hidden in this woman. Because the Bible says, he who finds a wife finds a good thing, finds that hidden treasure. But you have to work for it. And, you know, in the Bible, I know of a man who ended up working 14 years for a woman. And The first 7 years he labored, and it was like a day to him. But you know, on the night of the marriage, something, some transaction took place, and then the next morning he discovered that you know, it wasn't the proper thing. So I'd like you, so that you know, that you, this is the correct one. You are not shortchanged. You don't have to labor another 7 years. In fact, it ended up being 21 years serving that father-in-law. So in order for it not to go that long, I'd like you to lift up the veil and confirm to us that this is indeed Valerie that you have been given. Is she the one? They were not going to give you another. Oscar. You have taken Valerie to be your wife. Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, to be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Please repeat this after me. Say, I, Oscar.
I, Oscar.
Take you, Valerie.
Take you, Valerie.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish
and you. And to cherish you.
To love you unconditionally.
To love you unconditionally.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Until death.
Until death.
Do us part.
Do us part.
I promise.
I promise.
To care for you.
To care for you.
And to lead you.
And to lead you.
And guide you.
And guide you.
In paths of righteousness.
In paths of righteousness.
Provide for your needs.
Provide for your needs.
In this life.
In this life.
I do hereby. Separate myself.
Separate myself.
From my father and mother.
From my father and mother.
And covenant with you.
And covenant with you.
To be a faithful husband to you.
To be a faithful husband to you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Valerie, you have taken Oscar to be your husband. Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, to be faithful to him, as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Please repeat this after me. I, Valerie.
I, Valerie.
Take you, Oscar.
Take you, Oscar.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
My lawful wedded husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
From this day forward, in the presence of our family,
and friends,
I offer you my solemn vow
to be your faithful partner,
to be your faithful wife,
in sickness and in health,
in good times
and in bad,
in joy
and in sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To support you in your goals.
To support you in your goals.
To honor you.
To honor you.
Respect you.
Respect you.
To love with you.
To love with you.
And to laugh with you.
To laugh with you.
And cry with you.
And cry with you.
To cherish you.
To cherish you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I take you now as my husband.
Now,
where you go,
where you go,
I will go.
Where you lodge,
I will lodge.
Your
people,
are my people. Your God is my God. Separate us. Amen. Before I ask these two to just share personal vows, I want to address you and as family and friends of Oscar and Valerie. Will you, the people that have come to witness this grand ceremony, as friends and relatives of Oscar and Valerie, promise to do all in your power to uphold these two in their marriage? May I hear you?
Yes.
How come I only heard this section and everybody else was quiet? Will you?
Yes.
See, the scripture says what God has joined. Yes, yes. So anatete ndakona imchipruza pamchi waridza Mazambia and so forth. Don't become the ones that will bring a wedge between these two. I pray that you continue to cheer them on. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'd like to give this time to Oscar to just say vows from the bottom of his heart to some words, to give, to vow, and a vow that you also do the same. That is really book.
Okay. I don't want to die. To the finest lady in the land.
Yeah.
First, I want to say that this is the day that God has made. I am glad, and I know you are glad, and we're rejoicing in it with family and friends. Today marks another milestone in our journey, a journey that may have not started with us willfully participating in it. I know you've been telling everyone that I have been following you for a long time. But the truth is, you have been the one who's been following me. My parents enrolled me in primary school in Elite Primary, and a few years later, you decided to join me there. I left Elite to went to Jamison High School. You could have gone to any other high school, but you decided to come there too. I left high school, went to college, started my career in Bulawayo, and lo and behold, you were there. I lived Zim, came down to Cape Town, and I find you in church. Ultimately, I believe you have been following me all your life, and I'm glad that you are now part of my life. And I believe I would like you to follow me as we go on the journey together. Everything that God does, and everything that he does is beautiful in its time, and we've come here by the hand of God. And only his hand will sustain us. And I believe as long as we follow God together, we'll be strong. I cherish every moment that I've had with you on this journey, and I believe that there'll be even more moments that will come our way, and I'll cherish them even more. But I don't think there'll ever be a moment as special as the one I'm sharing with you right now. And I'm saying this in front of my friends and family and my pastors, that I have an undying love for you. You've been such a blessing to me, an answer to a prayer that I made when I was driving to work one day. After reading in the Bible that Sarah was very beautiful, and I said, God, may you give me my Sarah. By the way, may she be able to cook very well. And there you appeared. You're very beautiful, not only on the outside, but also on the inside. And you're an answer to prayer. I love you very much, and I hope that the rest of our days we feel with much happiness and joy as we build a firm house together. I love you, Valerie.
Yeah!
Oscar, I've known you since high school. I couldn't have imagined in my wildest dreams I'll be standing here with you today. God does have a sense of humor. Having come from the same town and gone to the same schools, only to meet and fall in love in Cape Town, it's moments like these that make me realize God's timing is always the right time. Over the past few years, I've learned so many things about you. Your love and commitment to God is so evident in the way you love me. You are so many things I prayed so many years for. You care for people, you are gentle, patient, kind, and most importantly, you always try and see me through God's eyes. I promise to always put God first in our family and to always pursue a passionate relationship with Jesus. I promise to love you as you are and respect you as my husband. I promise to honor you and submit to your leadership for our family. Lastly, I promise to love you forever and a day.
Valerie, I would like you to stretch forth your left hand and stretch it here. And I'll hold it. I'll hold the rings. And then I want to pronounce a blessing over them. Heavenly Father, we just want to bless this ring, which is to be a sign of the vows by which Oscar and Valerie are binding themselves to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I'd like you to take and put in the left forefinger. And put it completely. So stretch forth your yes. And Father, we extend our blessing even to this ring, which is a symbol of an unending love between Valerie and Oscar. We pray, my God, that it signifies that unending love for one another, faithfulness, commitment, sacrificial love. We say bless this ring in its symbolism to this unit in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Now now Oscar and Valerie. Maybe these guys have been seeing all these cameras and they think that this is just a cheap game. I'd like you to wave at them and show them this ring to say bye-bye, especially to the... Now that Oscar and Valerie have exchanged vows with the joining of hands and the blessing of the rings, I now pronounce this marriage blessed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Those whom God has joined, let no man put us under. Oscar, you may now kiss the bride. To light up a candle representing each of the individual lives that walked in this place, and then they are going to light one big candle and then put off those individual candles to say these two have become one flesh. So if you can walk towards I don't know how to light that match at all, but I'm sure McDonald will help you. And the best man and the best lady will help you. The Bible says in Genesis, you know, for this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother's house, and the two shall be joined together, and they shall become one flesh. This candle represents one flesh. So on your first wedding anniversary, we want to see that thing on. On your 5th, on your 10th, on your 25th, please light up that candle. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Made a way. Don't know how, but you did it. Made a way. Standing here, not knowing how we'll get through this test, but holding on to faith, you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out, and you're watching us now. And when it looks as if we can't win, wrap within your arms and step in, and everything we need you to supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you made a way. When our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made our way. I'm from. Because of you and nothing we've done to deserve the love and mercy you've shown. But your grace was strong enough to pick us up. And you made our way.
On this 25th of August 2018, I need break calendar 5778. It is my singular and greatest pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Oscar Nembaware. Jesus' mighty name. Amen.